Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, I'm going to show you how to check bounce rate in Google Analytics 4. Okay, so we're looking at Google's demo property, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by showing you how to create an exploration report that includes our bounce rate. So let's navigate to Explore, and this is where you can create all of your ad hoc or custom reports in Google Analytics. I'm going to start from scratch, so let's go ahead and click blank, and this allows us to build our report. So we're going to name our report, I'm just going to name it bounce rate. And now we need to add in the building blocks, so basically the dimensions, which will be the rows of information, and the metrics, which will be the columns of data. In this particular case, of course, we're focused on bounce rate. So let's start with dimensions, and for this particular report, we're going to do pages. There's a range of different page-based dimensions you can use in Google Analytics 4. I'm going to go with page path and screen class. So that will show us all the different individual pages, in this case from Google's demo site. So let's go ahead and click import. So we have our dimension, and let's add in the metrics that we want to use. So I might include sessions as one metric. So I'm going to select sessions, and let's also add in, of course, bounce rate. So we can add in bounce rate as well. You can go ahead and add additional metrics. Maybe you also want to have users, for example, maybe active users or total users in your report. So once you're happy, click on import. We can then see those building blocks on the left-hand side, and to add them into our report, we can either drag them in or just double-click on them. So I'm going to double-click page path, and I'm also going to double-click sessions, bounce rate, and active users. So now what we actually have is we've built up our report, and we can see for Google's demo store, so the demo GA4 property, we can now see the bounce rate for the different pages people are viewing on the website. So that's one way to see bounce rate in Google Analytics 4, and that's by creating an exploration report. Now you also, apart from creating an exploration report, you might also want to add bounce rate into your standard reports. So the standard reports are under the report section in Google Analytics. There's a whole range of different standard reports. If you'd like to learn more about these, then do check out my Google Analytics 4 tutorial. I'll include a link in the description below this video, or also check out my course. Again, there's a link in the description. So basically, through these different sets of reports, you might want to add in bounce rate. Let's just take a quick look before we do that. So we're in acquisition and then traffic acquisition. This shows you all the different methods people are using to find your website, or in this particular case, Google's demo site, which is the Google Merchandise Store. Now, while this default report doesn't include bounce rate, it does include another metric, which is called engagement rate. And this is like the converse of bounce rate. So this shows you the percentage of sessions that are actually engaged rather than unengaged on your website. So you will find this in the default report, but if you are focused on bounce rate, then what you'll need to do is you'll actually need to edit the standard reports. Now in Google's demo property here, I don't have the correct level of permission to edit the reports, of course. So I'm going to open up my own demo property. I've already opened up the report section. So let's travel back in. I'm going to open the same report, but you can, of course, edit the other reports in your own Google Analytics 4 property as well. So I've opened up that traffic acquisition report that we were just looking at in the demo property, because I do have the correct level of permission in this property. On the top right-hand corner, we can see this little pencil icon. As we hover over it, it says customized report. So look for that in your Google Analytics 4 property. And then we can click on this. And this allows us to modify what's included in the report. So we can modify like the dimensions we just saw in the exploration report, but this time in a standard report. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select on metrics. We can see all of the default metrics in this report, including that engagement rate we just saw in the demo property. But at the bottom here, what we can do is we can click on add metric. And then we can actually look for or search for bounce rate. So once you've found bounce rate, you can select it. You can put in where you want in terms of the column order. So maybe you want it after sessions, for example. When you're happy, click on apply, and you'll see the report actually update. So now what we can see is in my demo property, in my own demo property here, we can now see bounce rate reported by the different channel groups. So once you're happy with this, you can then save it. You can save it to the current report and click on save again. And what this will mean now is that the standard report has been modified to actually include bounce rate. So as we come back, whenever we open up this traffic acquisition report now, we'll see bounce rate included. And I just wanted to also highlight, apart from the traffic acquisition report, you can also, of course, modify your other reports in Google Analytics as well. So for example, you might want to modify the default pages and screens report to also include bounce rate. So again, open the report you want to adjust, click on customize on the top right hand corner, look for metrics, and then you can add in a bounce rate into your reports and just follow the steps to save that report as a default. So that's how you can find and also add bounce rate in your Google Analytics 4 reports. I hope that was helpful. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to like it and take a moment to subscribe to this channel for all of the latest updates. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.